Good afternoon. I'm Jeff Bai, and I want to welcome you to Product Development Showcase Theater. As we all realize, product development is an integral part of our business. We may not all realize, though, everything that's involved in the process. What this series hopes to do is share with you, the rest of the organization, the heartache, the joy, the triumph of product development at Black & Decker. We will use the Kitchen Tools Project to give you all an inside glimpse of how the process evolves, how teams are formed, how products are designed and engineered, and how upper management guides the process with a steady hand throughout. So sit back now, relax, and share with us the development of Kitchen Tools. Okay, Keith, shut it off. Keith. That's fine, Keith. Keith, shut the damn camera off. What's this? Somebody left something on my desk. That's odd.
Jeff, you have been selected for a very important assignment, one which will require all of your product development skills and a very talented team. You have been selected to lead the assault on the premium kitchen appliance market. The project code name is Kitchen Tools. This tape will self-destruct in 10 seconds.
10 seconds? The honeymoon's over. I better get moving. There. Finally, the hard part's done. I've got all the lines drawn in. Now it's just a matter of dropping in some names and we're off to the races. Let me see. How do I get started on this? I should probably have some engineers. That'd be a good place to start. Hey, Sue, get me Paul Holbrook.
Paul Holbrook.
Paul, Jeff Bai wants to talk to you.
Sue, do you know what he wants?
He says he needs you for an important new product line.
I'm kind of tied up right now. Tell him I'll be there in a minute. Better make that two.
Boy, this is gonna be tough. Ann says this takes great marketing to launch this product line, and Don keeps calling it Marketing 808, and every time they say that, they're looking at me. And I've got the boat going in the water, I've got staff meetings going on. What am I gonna do? Oh, wait a minute, I got it. Sue, Jeff, hey look, get me Africa right away. Thanks.
Can't do it.
I got here as fast as I could.
Thank God. We've got design guides to do, we've got marketing plans to do, we've got advertising plans
to
write, we've got packaging
plan.
To do, we've got all... Well, Dan, looks like it's just you and me on this project.
Yeah, I wish we can get Bob St. John back.
Wow, what the hell's going on here? What am I doing here?
We just wished you back in the Kitchen Tools team.
Looks like it worked.
I guess it did.
Well,
and we should try this again. I wish Joe Molnar was back.
Want an apple?
Boy, this program management stuff is not easy. But they told me they'd put this PS6 software in here and I'd be a proficient program manager. God damn it. What am I gonna do? I've gotta get somebody that can do this and knows this, how to manage these programs. Who can I get? Holbrook? God, he's worse at it than I am. Oh, I have an idea. Okay, Kath, I'd like you to take these files. Let's cross-reference them with the CC mails that we printed this morning. Then let's take a look at the audixes that you printed out this morning for me. Hi, Jeff. I'll be with you in a second.
Take your time.
From there, let's take the directive D3AE, take a look at how that cross-referenced with D3AQ and D6M. We'll get the plants involved on this. We'll get the SOPs from Ashboro and Quanton. Make sure SOP 3-6N aligns. And then let's take a look at GPA.
I think
make
I sure found
GPA
my program
in
manager.
Line with D6N also.
Hey, thanks for coming down to this team meeting. Man, we got great stuff to talk about. We're talking trinkets. Ah, this is great. Look, food prep basics. We got can openers, we got knives. They're a little overpriced, but it's okay. I swear, they'll still buy it. We got some other stuff. Some other stuff. I love some other stuff. Popcorn makers, pink, purple, red. Ah, they love it. This is great. I'm telling you, they're going to love this. Yeah?
Hey, Rob.
Yeah?
Don Graber's on your phone. He wants to talk about the next National Presto widget, trinket or something.
Oh, my ship's coming. See you guys.
Okay, get him out of here. Ellis, trinkets, food prep basics, it's a wonderful thing. But it's not kitchen tools, and that's what we're here to talk about.
Boy, these numbers are brutal. Just brutal. I'm going to have to get a financial powerhouse on this case, or this will never fly.
Standard symptoms?
Dan, it's worse. I've got irritated cash flow, limp IRR, and I'm at a loss as to how to save it. Can you help?
Well, I'll see what I can do. It's a pretty pitiful product. Why don't I work on it? I'll give you a call.
Okay. Do what you can.
Okay. 1960 style. I see what the problem is. High cost, outdated styling, commodity product. I'll see what I can do. See, I've got to take out some of the cost, add a little style, see a touch of price. Ah, this will do it. Ah, that's much better. Jeff, it's Dan. I have something for you. Come on down.
Jeff, come on in. I think I've got what you need. What do you think?
My God. Will it work?
Of course it'll work. Just have it take $2 million worth of advertising and call me in the morning.
Dan, you are a god. Thank you. I can't wait to try it.
I'm glad I could help. Bye, Jeff. Jeff, bye. Whatever. Stupid name, anyway.
You know, the team is almost complete. But if we're not careful, we're going to actually have to go out and talk to real customers.
No, don't make me do it.
You know how distasteful that is.
That's awful.
I think we need to make a phone call and get some help.
Hey, I'm tired of this. You guys don't know who I am. If you do, you're not taking me seriously. I'm tired of looking at everybody else's basic out there, and it looks like mine. You're not giving me enough co-op to advertise what I do have.
Right.
And what I do have, I can't make any margin on. There's nothing sheltered. There's nothing new.
Okay, but...
Oh, wait, one second. Don't go anywhere.
Okay.
No, don't worry. You guys need to change the game strategy. Give
hey,
me something
hang on,
new.
Hang on.
Give me something
hey.
Different. There's nothing...
This is Keith Bernard. Hey, Jeff, what's going on? Part of a new kitchen tools team. Okay, but there's some things that, I've got some opinions about all this. One, we need some margin. And there's usually not enough margin on our products. We need some margin for, there's enough for us and the retailer. Okay. Sounds good. What about being sheltered, though? Is this stuff going to be over in Walmart? No? Not even if McKinsey says it has to be? It doesn't matter. We're going to put it where we want it to be. Good. I like that. All right. Co-op, There is enough co-op. There's more than enough co-op. Okay, well, then only the other thing of the things I need to be aware of is, can we get team shirts? You bet. Oh, great. Count me in.
Something different. Give me something I can make margin on, and give me something that I have co-op dollars to advertise it with. You guys need to change the game strategy. This is ridiculous.
I think we can help you out.
A different product. Give me the...
What a surprise. Well, I guess I'll just have to send him an Audex. Hey, great. Thanks for seeing me, Don, on such short notice. But look, I've done everything you've asked me to do. I've worked like crazy to pull this team together, and we finally got everybody in place. We've worked real, real hard to get the capital and all the numbers put together. We submitted it down to Towson a couple of weeks ago, and quite frankly, we haven't heard anything now. So I'm thinking, just to keep this thing moving real fast, I'll give Nolan a call myself. You don't want me to do that. Well, okay, how about you give Nolan a call and grovel on our behalf one more time? You'll do that? Oh, you want me to leave. Okay, well, good. Thanks a lot, Don. I appreciate it. Everything's ready to go. The products are almost designed, and all we're waiting for now is the word from Don that the capital's been approved. Oh, look, an Audex light. Maybe this is it.
This is an Audex to the staff and to Jeff By. Subject is Kitchen Tools Capital. The capital's approved to proceed with implementation. Take care. Bye.
You've now seen the team form for Kitchen Tools. You've seen the momentum build. You've seen the direction established. Let's take a closer look now at the engineering and product development process. Engineering, as we all know, is a very exact science. Lots of risks, lots of reward, lots of long hours. The team on Kitchen Tools has done a tremendous job. But it hasn't been without its high points and low points. We'd like to share some of those with you now. So sit back and welcome to the world of Kitchen Tools Engineering.
In the course of reviewing our competitors, we identified areas where we feel we could offer significant competitive advantages. If, for example, Dan were to take a conventional hand mixer, which uses a highly inefficient AC motor with worm drive, it needs a cooling fan because of all the heat it throws off. When you turn it on, but with our model, which uses a highly efficient DC motor with spur gears, there is a significant difference. Moving on to the stand mixer. As anyone who has ever owned a KitchenAid can attest, it can be difficult to add ingredients or to scrape the bowl during operation due to the space required by the planetary drive system. Our unit will have the beater placed at the rear of the bowl, and the bowl will rotate around it. There are several high-end coffee makers on the market. One issue you always have to be careful of, however, is draft breakage. Our coffee maker will have an unbreakable stainless steel vacuum carafe. As far as food processors go, Cuisinart is our competition. One problem with this unit, however, is the complexity of parts you need to assemble in order to use the unit. Now, if, for example, I were to ask Mr. Plavkin here to assemble these parts within 20 seconds and inform him that his performance on this simple test in no way will reflect on his performance appraisal, I'm sure he could meet the challenge. Go! Nice effort there, Dan. Take a break.
that.
Here we find our friend, Mr. St. John, who is mixing up his favorite concoction to help make it through the day. Now, normally, it would be a relatively simple task for him to lift this 7-pound blender jar and to pour. But if his hands tend to be slippery, or if his judgment is impaired, or in this case, both, it could prove difficult. Now, our blender jar will have a non-slip rubber handle grip. That one's yours, by the way.
Thanks.
Lastly, here we find Mr. Molnar, who is obviously entertaining some Hawaiian friends. He's going to need some pineapple juice in a hurry. But if he's using a competitive unit, which is not stable enough to support this juice can, it could be embarrassing. Just a sampling of some of the use characteristics and performance issues where we feel we can offer significant competitive advantages. Through objective kitchen and lab testing, our goal is to achieve best-in-class performance, use characteristics, and food results ratings. Combine our engineering with the unique and compelling industrial design, and we have a product line we are all proud to be part of.
Well, I've only got a few more minutes to talk to you here, because the rest of the team is now waiting for me as we begin to take our next step. As you can see, we've got a lot of successful things going on, and now we are going to move up as a team to the next step. Another thing you'll notice is, as I move out of this video into the next video, I have a different shirt and tie on. That's because we shot some of this yesterday, but don't let that bother you. Anyway, join me now as myself and the Kitchen Tool team moves to the next level.